I'm Gregory Dent. I am the owner of Greg's Reinventions. I do upcycled and refined woodworking. Basically none. I knew about it through online content, few sources that YouTubers typically that got into it in their shop. And I thought, well, you know, that's not woodworking. Why are they doing that? That's ridiculous. That's not woodworking. But then I wound up getting curious about it and saw what they were doing with their CNCs. And it kind of put a spark in me to delve into it a little more. But up until that point, I knew nothing at all about it. The basic reasoning for me, as you know, I had a project that fell in my lap for a client. I owned a coffee shop and they wanted these 6x6 coffee mug
coasters.
Coffee coasters. They wanted these 6x6 coffee coasters, and that turned into quite the job. And so I tried to do it on my router table, and that turned out to no, that's not going to work out very well. It turned out very sloppy, despite my best efforts to put stop blocks in place and be able to control the spacing for the stop and start of the material. It just was not working out. And so I went online and I started searching CNC machines, KW, and your site came up in that first search, and I was shocked by what I saw. I watched a few videos you had online there, and then I looked at the pricing and saw the Mill 1 machine that you had. Thought, hey, that'd be pretty cool. I could put one coaster in, cut them out on my table saw out of a sheet of plywood, and put one coaster in at a time in the little machine and cut them out. That'd be fantastic. Well, then I had no idea, because there's no mention on your website that you were even looking at this bigger machine. And Bob's your uncle. I landed one. It came down to size and pricing. It was big enough to do projects that I thought I would get into, and the price was way more reasonable than anything else I saw on the market. There was no way I was going to be able to convince the love of my life to let me blow $4,000 or $5,000 on a machine, especially one I knew very little about. And when I saw what users were offering for the LongMill in the beta testing program, I had to pick my jaw up off the floor. I couldn't believe what users were offering in a machine of this type. It just blew my mind. So it was, for me, it was an absolute no-brainer. Good. It's been very good. I know I've had help from you guys, obviously, having known nothing about programming something like this. The help I got from you and Chris has been invaluable, and it's been able to allow me to design basic things and explore the how to advance, albeit slowly, into the world of CNC and get travel toward getting more out of it. The biggest thing though is how the quality of the products that you can make so quickly from a machine like this, and especially with the right bit, and there's almost no sanding after. There's very little prep needed for finishing. It's just been an all-round amazing experience with everything I've dealt with so far. Challenges, definitely the programming. That was a challenge. Getting even the basics took me a little while, but as I've said many times, even at the woodworking show, a couple hours of Chris sitting down with me and I was programming my own product and spitting out the other end. I wouldn't call it a stumbling block by any means. It was just something that, a little bit of a learning curve. But once you got over that, I think with experience with the machine and the programming, it opens itself up to so many new things that you can do with it. The joys, instant gratification when you see the product come off of the machine, and you can see the even something as silly as Baltic birch plywood and making those coasters, seeing the grain in the layers of the plywood underneath that are revealed was like, wow, who knew plywood could be so beautiful? Things like that are just, it just blows my mind that I was walking a foot off the ground in your shop, like I was on helium in my head with glee over what this machine was producing for me. You know, it was just, I was overwhelmed by it, that I could have something that nice pop out the other end of it at, when everything was said and done. Customers would request on my patio coolers, there's an area of about 30 by 12 that they would be able to have a logo or their name or their store or pub name burned into the face of it. So before I got the CNC machine, it was quite laborious venture. I would go to their website and take a GIF off of their website and send it to my printer and tell them what size I need it printed up, but flipped in reverse. So for the pub down the street, Strikers, I have a sample of what I would have printed. And as you can see, this is in reverse. And in the, what I would do then is put it down on the face of the cooler, and I take a heating iron and transfer the toner from the laser printer onto the wood. And then there's another step. You have to take your iron, pyrography tool, and burn the surface of the wood into to get the pattern permanent in the wood. Well, just one logo like this would take me almost all day to do the transfer and then do the burning. So I'd be 8 to 12 hours doing a logo like this. There's a lot of detail in it. So being able to have this machine, I can pre-assemble the front face of the cooler, put it in between the rails, and put a straight mill, quarter inch mill or 1/8 mill, and have it write out everything with just an 1/8 inch deep, and then take it out of the mill and burn it after. And it's gonna significantly speed up the amount of time I'm hunched over a table burning all this, these logos into coolers or even something like this. I'm making charcuterie board for my mother-in-law, and I affectionately call her Mama Bear, because there's only three in their family. There's her, Mama Bear, my father-in-law, Papa Bear, and my wife, Baby Bear. So I'm going to put Mama Bear's Bistro on a charcuterie board for her. And we'll have video of that hopefully later, showing how that's done. It would be perfect for anybody that wants to do hobby stuff, making parts to make kids' toys. You could virtually cut a whole train set out on one of these machines, cut every part out, all the wheels, all of the pieces to make the individual cars, all the connections between the cars, and have it all cut out. Once it's done, just put it all together, glue it, nail it, whatever you want to do, and you could have it all done in a few hours. And then you run out of parts, you take the file for the parts you need, cut out a few more, and away you go. It would be very easy to take anything. I know a lot of woodworkers from different forums, they have drives at the end of the year to make toys for kids that are in hospitals. Maybe they're not feeling good, or they're very sick. Some of them do toys for kids that have cancer, and they're in cancer wards, things like that. If you want something to speed up the production for something like that, you cannot get a better tool than something like this. So you can take something that is tedious, like cutting out hundreds of parts for something like that, and turn it into a Saturday afternoon and have all your parts cut in one afternoon. It's really easy. The other side of that is schools could take this and train kids how to program CNC machines in the high school level or even junior high level. So many kids are into doing robotics. My own nephew took a robotics course a year or two ago from over, I think it was spring break, he took that. And I know that if he had this available in the robotics course, that so many kids would see the practical application other than just building a robot. They could control this and make things for their mom or dad, and get a kick out of doing that. This machine is sturdy enough and rock solid enough that you could have this in a small production shop. You could have this in a factory. The only limiting thing is if you're doing things bigger than 30 by 30, well, maybe you modify it a little bit to accommodate what you're doing. It wouldn't be that hard. It is expandable, modifiable. Lots of guys put lasers on them and do laser cutting or laser etching, things like that. It's unlimited, the things that you can do with one of these things. my experience with Andy and Chris has been outstanding. And I just want to say on the back end of this, if you're at all considering one of these but are worried about dealing with people that are seem younger than yourself or younger company than what you're usually dealing with, you've got nothing to worry about. These guys are here to stay, and the integrity that they have shown to me and others that I've witnessed is just incredible. The workmanship that they put into these machines is just fantastic. You don't have to worry about warranty problems. You don't have to worry about not being able to get help. They're always coming up with ways to help the people that buy their machines. Go to their website, cnc.com, sienci.com, and sign up for their email. Look at their Facebook page, and you will see a world of people that are there to help you out.